Good morning to all of you. I welcome you all in our lecture series on statistical mechanics, that is your core paper 14, belongs to 6th semester BSc syllabus. In our last class, we have been discussed about entropy of a perfect gas using the classical microcanonical ensemble. In detail, we have been discussed and we found this is the entropy, but it could not be accept universal, means distinguishable particle, and for non-distinguishable particle, it will be accepted for distinguishable particle. However, not to accepted for non-distinguishable particle. This type of problem also we have been faced whenever we have been discussed Gibbs paradox. According to Gibbs, we have to adapt the quantum concept, and by using quantum concept we are going to found the corrected entropy will be this one. In detail we have been discussed in our last class. This is also called as your Sackler tetraoid equation, and in today class we are going to be from here, whenever n factorial is going to be divided with a W, then this expression will be come out here. It has been written directly, but how it will be, that explanation I have been done here. Okay, also this explanation also in our last class we have been discussed. Okay, so today we are going to discuss thermodynamical functions of ideal gas. So sometimes also it is called as the quantities, okay, thermodynamic functions or quantities of ideal or perfect gas, or ideal or perfect gas. Here we are going to calculate the thermodynamical functions or quantities by using the entropy, whatever we found from your microcanonical ensemble. I told in that video that this is sigma is equal to W represents statistical entropy. However, thermodynamical entropy related with statistical entropy as this one is equal to Boltzmann constant into statistical entropy. Okay. So, using this expression, we are going to find out the quantities, thermodynamic function or quantities, like your entropy, internal energy, then relation between T and P, and your chemical potential of a perfect gas. Okay. So, here I suggest to all of you that before you have to watch this video, you just go for the last video, it will be better for you. Now starts entropy. Here S is represents thermodynamical entropy of a perfect or ideal gas. We just put this heading. We know that S equal to K sigma. K is Boltzmann constant, sigma is statistical entropy. Already we sigma obtained here. Equation number 12. We have to just multiply K with this. We can get the S value. So S will be equal to, if I am going to multiply K, then NK here log base E this much plus 5 by 2 NK. Only just I have been considered equation number right by considering equation number 12 of previous discussion. Just write, I don't have space, but I adjusted, but you have to write clearly. Okay, so by considering equation number 12 of our previous discussion, this one equation number 12, here I go just multiplied K. And in our last class also I told that you can write this is as ln. Instead of writing log E, you can write ln also, no problem. Okay. So we found the entropy, thermodynamical entropy will be this one. This expression of entropy of a perfect gas is called Sackware-Tetraed formula or equation. This expression also we found whenever we have been discussed Gibbs paradox. Okay. This is one of the, you can say, standard equation which supports both your distinguishable and indistinguishable particle. Okay. Now, internal energy. So, previously we know that T equal to del E by del S at constant V. Here previously means we studied this expression in our third semester. Okay. In our thermodynamics paper. So, 1 by T will be del S by del E at constant V. Here V is the volume. Now, we have to consider Sackware-Tetraed expression of entropy. That is your, this is equation number 1 we have to use to find out 1 by T. So, here 1 by T will be del by del E of S. S means this one. Carefully, you have to substitute. So, any constant written outside del by del E of this is log E I written, okay, log E or you can write ln, and whatever these all expressions I haven't written here, V by N 4 pi M by 3 to the power 3 by 2 into E by N to the power 3 by 2 whole divided by HQ plus 5 by 2 NK bracket square bracket closed at constant V. Okay. Now we have to just simplify something. NK del by del E, keep it. Now here L log E V by N, then plus this term plus log E 4 pi M by 3 to the power 3 by 2 plus here this one 3 by 2 log E here E by N, so 3 by 2 log E N, then this one minus log E HQ, and this term is 5 by 2 NK at constant V. Okay. Next, 1 by T will be equal to NK del by del E of 3 by 2 log E. Here you can see only this term is the function of E and all other terms are constant. See, here from the initial we considered V is constant. So here V by N will be constant because total number of particle is N. So V by N will be constant. So if I am going to take the derivative of this one, I am going to get the zero value. So this is also constant. We can get zero. Here also we can get zero. Here also we can get zero because H is constant. NK also constant. So this term will be zero if we are going to be differentiate with respect to E. So only one term has been left, that is your 3 by 2 log E. Here I am again and again telling that instead of log E, you can write ln. From the beginning itself, I am telling here you can write ln. Here you can write ln. Here also you can write ln in your note. Now we have to move for the next page. So it will 1 by 2 NK 3 by 2 into 1 by E. Okay. So if I am going to differentiate this one, it will be 1 by E. Del E by del E log E will be nothing but 1 by E. Okay. So we found 1 by T equal to NK into 3 by 2 into 1 by E. That implies E equal to 3 by 2 NKT. This is your internal energy of a perfect monoatomic gas. Okay. So here I am going to show you one thing, that whenever we have been discussed partition function and thermodynamical quantities, at that time we have been substituted E equal to 3 by 2 NKT directly here in this expression 7, in this equation 7, and we found this expression. So at that time I told that I will tell that how this E equal to 3 by 2 NKT. So 3 by 2 nkt in this way we found. Okay, 3 by 2 nkt. Okay, now we have to substitute this e value 3 by 2 nkt in our equation number 1. This is your cyclotetraid equation or formula. Here we are going to use instead of e 3 by 2 kt, 3 by 2 nkt. So here s will be equal to nk log base e v by n 4 pi m by 3 to the power 3 by 2 into this. Instead of e we are going to write 3 by 2 nkt by n to the power 3 by 2 whole divided by h cube plus 5 by 2 nk, and we are going to found s equal to nk log e v by n 2 pi m k t by h square to the power 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2 nk. Same expression we have been found whenever at the time of discussing the Gibbs paradox. You can check your note. I am going to show you. Wait. Here you can see the corrected version. This is your corrected version of entropy. Whenever we are discussing the Gibbs paradox, this is your corrected entropy nk ln v by n 2 pi mkt to the power 3 by 2 by h cube 2 pi mkt to the power 3 by 2. Here h square to the power 3 by 2 will be h cube and plus 5 by 2 nk plus 5 by 2 nk. Okay, now it is matched. That means here by considering Gibbs paradox or with the help of the theoretical explanation of Gibbs paradox, we found cyclotetraid formula. By considering microcanonical ensemble also, we got the same. And in our forthcoming discussion lecture, we are also, whenever we are going to discuss class canonical ensemble, from the canonical ensemble also we are going to get the same, and same this equation. And from by considering grand canonical ensemble also we are going to get the same expression, cyclotetraid equation or formula. Okay, that we are going to be discussing in our forthcoming classes. Now relation between T and P. It is well known that here, it is well known that means we have been studied in our third semester, okay, in the thermodynamics paper, P by T equal to del S by del V at constant N and E, number of particle, total energy. Now entropy S from equation number 1 or 2, either you can use equation number 2 or equation number 1. So it will be del by del V of nk log ev, and other terms is going to be 0. Why? You can see that other terms here we expanded the things. You can see here we expanded the terms previous. Here you can see that function of v term is only here, and other terms will be constant. Here e is the term is there, but we have been considered that e is also constant. So if we are going to be expand the equation number 1, then we can found like this. Okay, so here among these terms only this term contains v, and other terms are constant whenever we are going to consider differentiation with respect to v. Okay, and here you can see log v by n can be written as log v minus log n, so that log n also not to be considered, only log v we are going to be consider. So it will be, finally we can get del by del v nk log e v. Here also I written other terms not be considered as contains constants. Okay, what I explained. Now p by t will be ln v derivative respect to v will be 1 by v. So p v will be equal to nkt. Let it is your equation number 3. I suggest you remember this expression, this expression you remember, maybe it will be asked in your exam as short question. Okay, now we have to move for chemical potential which is symbolized by mu. of a perfect gas. So it is known that minus mu by T equal to del S by del N at constant E V. Okay. So here we have to put instead of S equal to this much, whatever we found, either you can consider one or two equation previously. Here we have been, I have been considered equation number two. Okay. So NK log E V by N 2 pi MKT to the power 3 by 2 by H square plus 5 by 2 NK, whatever your equation number 2, right? So now consider thermal de Broglie wavelength associated with a molecule. So thermal de Broglie wavelength is nothing but H by average thermal momentum. This is momentum. This is N, not R, M-U-M, momentum of a molecule. We know that in our last semester, lambda, according to de Broglie, lambda is nothing but H by MV. So, denominator is the dimension of momentum. So, here average thermal momentum of a molecule. So, in the above expression or equation 4, 2 pi M KT to the power 1 by 2 has the character of an average thermal momentum of a molecule. Okay, so here it has been calculated that 2 pi m kT to the power 1 by 2 represents the average thermal momentum of a molecule. Here I have been written directly. There is a derivation, but it is not required in your, according to your syllabus. You have to just remember now. So in future, maybe you are going to be found the derivation of this one, that how the average thermal momentum of a molecule will be 2 pi mkt to the power 1 by 2. Okay. So here you just remember 2 pi kt to the power 1 by 2 represents average thermal momentum of a molecule. So hence lambda will be equal to H by 2 pi mkt to the power 1 by 2. Right. Now we have to use this lambda in our equation number 4. Okay. Then how much it will be? See, that implies mu minus mu by T. That implies minus mu by T equal to del by del n nk L log E del by del n nk log E V by N, this one 2 pi m k t by h square can be written as 1 by h q. Got it? You can see here if I am going to use lambda value equal to h by 2 pi m k t to the power 1 by 2, then it will be, I am going to show you, wait. Here 1 by lambda q, here I have been written, lambda value is nothing but h by 2 pi mkt to the power 1 by 2. That is h by 2 pi mkt to the power 1 by 2 to the power 3 by 2. So it will be 1 by h by, sorry, this will be how much? Here I written mistakenly. This is only 2 pi kt to the power 1 by 2. Lambda value is nothing but h by 2 pi kt to the power 1 by 2. So instead of lambda, I have to put h by 2 pi kt to the power 1 by 2. So it will be hq 2 pi m kt to the power 3 by 2. So we can found, this can be moved to the numerator, 2 pi m kt to the power 3 by 2 by hq, right? Or it can be written as 2 pi mkt by h square to the power 3 by 2. Okay, same thing. Okay, so instead of 2 pi kt by h square to the power 3 by 2, we can write 1 by lambda q plus 5 by 2 nk. Okay, now del by del n of this one, देन आज दिस इज वन बाय लैम्डा क्यू कैन बी रिटन एज एन के लॉग ई लैम्डा क्यू प्लस डेल बाय डेल एन ऑफ फाइव बाय टू एन के. ओके नाउ डेल बाय डेल एन ऑफ एन के हियर वी बाय एन इज देयर सो वी कैन राइट लॉग ई वी माइनस एन के लॉग ई एन. अगेन आई एम टेलिंग दैट इंस्टेड ऑफ लॉग ई यू कैन राइट सिंपली एल एन. ओके सिंपली एल एन इन जनरलाइज आई हैव बीन रिटन बट यू कैन राइट एल एन वी नो प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज दिस विल बी एन माइनस एन के लॉग ई लैम्डा क्यू और एल एन एल एन लैम्डा क्यू प्लस फाइव बाई टू योर डिफरेंशिएशन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एन वी कैन फाउंड फाइव बाई टू के. ओके नाउ नाउ डिफरेंशिएट दिस वन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एन we can found k log e v. okay now differentiate this one n k log e n. first consider first consider here we are going to do the product formula. see here n is there, here n is there, so obviously we are going to use the product formula of the differentiation. So consider first consider derivative of this one will be 1 by n. So it will be c minus n k into 1 by n then plus minus is your man minus the derivative of this one will be k log e n, right? So same thing it has been written. So here n n got cancelled. So minus k only we can found. Minus k, another term is minus k log e n. Minus k log e n. Here I given hyphen means this term you have to write here. Minus k log e n. Then this term. Here n k log e lambda q means we are with respect to dn is going to be derivative means it will be only minus k log e lambda q minus k log e lambda q plus 5 by 2 k. Here I have to erase these things. Okay now that implies mu by t equal to k. here k can be taken outside. So log e v, here you can see that your log e n minus log e n, here you can see minus log e lambda q, n and lambda q will become to the denominator side. Okay so log e v by n lambda q. Now here it is minus k, this is plus 5 by 2, that means minus 1 plus 5 by 2, it will be 3 by 2. So 3 by 2, k already taken outside. So now it will be mu by t minus is going to be multiplied with right hand side, it will be k. here just carefully you have to watch, this is log e v by n lambda q. Whenever I am going to multiply minus, then it will just reverse. It will be just reverse. K log e n lambda q by v. Okay. And minus 3 by 2. Why it will be? So, see. Log e v by n lambda q is there. So, if it will be minus log e n, sorry, v n lambda q, it can be written as log e v minus log n lambda q, right? So it here it is minus, means this will be minus log e v plus log e n lambda q, that implies log e n lambda q by v. Okay so here only for that it will be just, I told that it will be reverse, actually it will not reverse, Minus means these things happens. These steps I have been omitted. Okay. So it will be n lambda q by v minus 3 by 2. Okay. These things also I have to erase. Then from section 3 we found, that means the relation between P and T. Here P by T we found nk by v, right? P by T we found nk by v, so we are going to be use that one. That one, so mu by T will be equal to k log e n by v. So instead of n by v, you can see, so that implies n by v will be nothing but p by tk, right? So instead of n by v, we can write p by tk, p by tk. So it will be k into log e p by tk lambda q minus 3 by 2. So mu will be equal to just multiply t with each term. So it will be tk log e p, okay, plus tk log e lambda q by tk minus 3 by 2 kt. Okay. So that implies mu will be equal to, actually in general we are always pronouncing that kt. Tk is sounds not good, kt sounds good. So with that format I have been written once again this expression, mu equal to kt log ep plus kt log lambda log e lambda q by kt minus 3 by 2 kt. That is your expression, equation number 5. Again I am going to tell to you that here instead of log e you can write ln, no problem. Okay, for watching this video, write down the note perfectly, and in our next class we are going to discuss perfect monoatomic gas in canonical ensemble. Whatever we discussed by considering microcanonical ensemble, but in our next class we are going to consider canonical ensemble, perfect monoatomic gas in canonical ensemble. For that we have to define the partition function, and from the partition, using the partition function, this will be the partition function, and by using the partition function we are going to be find out thermodynamical functions or quantities for canonical ensemble in terms of partition function Z. Here also we are going to get the same entropy expression, that is your Sackway tetroid equation, same equation we are going to be found. That means in any ensemble we are going to consider, the Sackway tetroid equation is a universal acceptable expression as per the thermodynamics concern. So this is the standard form of entropy. By using this we can solve the physical parameters or macroscopic behavior of a thermodynamic system. So here by using canonical ensemble also we can get the same that we are going to discuss in our next class. Then internal energy will be how much according to canonical ensemble, that also we are going to discuss. Okay, so I suggest you just write the today's discussion, whatever we discussed, four relations we have been discussed. Okay, four relations carefully you have to watch and write down. Okay, thank you so much for watching this. Thank you.